Welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the Luminar AI Eyes tools to make your portraits pop. With the Face AI tools in Luminar AI, eyes can be enhanced quickly and easily to add sparkle, brighten them, add a splash of color, or fix things like red eye or squinting. Hi, I'm Darlene with Digital Photo Mentor. With over 30 years as a professional photographer, my goal is to share my experience and skills to help you improve your photos right from capture all the way through to the end of the editing process. As a Skylum ambassador, I'll show you how easy it is to use Luminar AI as part of that process so that you could follow along and get the same results with your images too. If you enjoy this video, remember to like it and hit subscribe to the channel. Let's get started. Okay, here we are inside of Luminar AI. This is a lovely model that I used when I was filming my portrait fundamentals course. I'm going to give you a tip from that course if you stick around to the end of this video on shooting portraits. But in this one, we're going to talk about how to edit the portraits and specifically the eyes. So when you're inside of Luminar AI, scroll down on the tools menu here on the right hand side until you get to the portrait section. And the ones we're going to be looking at in this video are the Face AI tools, particularly the ones in the eyes section. If you don't see this section, just hit the little down, up and down arrow to open the eyes or close the others that you don't want to see. So make sure that you can see this section here with the eyes. So we're going to start at the top, and that is the Iris AI. This is new inside of Luminar AI. So if you are familiar with Luminar 4 or earlier versions, you may have seen some of these portrait tools, but the Iris AI is new. So this one is really cool. It allows you to enhance specifically the iris or the colored part of the eyes. So I'm going to zoom in here just so we can see what I'm doing a little bit closer. So the first thing I want to do is talk about this slider called iris visibility. The higher or to the right you drag this one, the more the iris is going to be lit up or lightened. Okay, now her eyes are fairly dark, so it's not really doing very much here. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to change her eye color. Now you want to be careful of doing this. Make sure that it's not something that's inappropriate. So for somebody with her cultural background, she's not likely to have blue eyes. So I don't want to give her eye color that looks really, really fake. Okay, so I'm going to choose brown, which is closest to her original eye color. Now you see that what happens is now the iris visibility slider works really well, and I can dial up the color by going to the right or the brightness or down to the left. The next one down is the iris flare. What this does is it applies a little highlight under the eyes. Imagine you were holding a reflector. See how that highlight is happening right here on the bottom of her iris? Okay. So I want to bring that up a little bit, but you want to make sure you don't go too far with a lot of these edits so that she doesn't look like she's kind of the devil's spawn. So I'll show you what a good edit looks like, and then I'll show you what too far looks like as well. The next slider, just continuing down, is Enlarge Eyes. This is another one that I thought I would never use, but is actually really handy. If you have somebody that squints a lot, or you photograph them outdoors, or they tend to have one lazy eye, you can use the Enlarge Eyes and use it fairly sparingly, like keep it under 20 or so, to just ever so slightly look like their eyes are opening a little bit. So let's see what that's doing for her here. I'm going to turn this tool off, and you just use the little toggle switch here to do that. So that's without the tool. So you can see that it's enlarging her eyes and brightening up the color, but it's not gone too far that it looks sort of really unrealistic. I'll keep it there for now. Remember, I'll show you the unrealistic in a moment. So eye whitening, another one. If you go too far, you're going to end up with her eyes glowing. So keep it gentle, keep it subtle. Eye enhancer, this one takes the iris and adds that sparkle that I was talking about at the beginning. Okay, so it's going to give the irises more sort of clarity so that the lines and the speckles come out even more. I'll turn up the visibility a little bit more as well. So you can see what's happening with her eyes. If I do a full before and after, the color and the sparkliness of her eyes is really, really coming out. The red eye removal slider, tends to work if you have, you know, flash and you've received a reflection of the flash, or otherwise known as red eye, to remove that. I don't have that here. What I do have are some specular highlights at the top of her eyes. You can see those here. Those are actually desirable. Those are called catch lights. I'll talk more about catch lights at the end of the video, so stick around. I'm not going to use the red eye removal slider here because she doesn't have any. And she also doesn't have dark circles under her eyes, so if she had lines under her eyes, or maybe she had not gotten much sleep the night before, the dark circle removal works really well on that defect or flaw. The dark circle removal slider works really well on that aspect of the face if that's something that's prominent on your subject. Improve eyebrows does exactly what it sounds like. It darkens and sharpens the eyebrows. Again, I don't want to go too far because I don't want to make her look overly sort of monstrous, but let's just give her a little bit of enhanced eyebrow. I'm at 35. Okay, so one thing I do recommend whenever you're doing face retouching or eye retouching is that you zoom back out to sort of view the picture like full screen or fit to screen so that you can see it's not too far. Okay, you haven't gone too far. This is where I'm at now. Let's take a look at the before. Okay, and I'm just holding down the backslash key on the keyboard as the shortcut, or you can also use this little slider here to get you the before and after. This one's helpful if you want to see both eyes at the same time. Okay, so you can see what's happening is her eye is definitely being enhanced and brightened. Okay, so remember we talked about going too far? Let's see what that looks like. So literally, I'm just going to take everything to extreme, and we're gonna go like that. Okay, so you would generally never want to do something like this. Okay, so you already can see, I hope that you can see anyways, that this looks very unrealistic and she looks sort of demonic. And when we zoom out, it looks even more so, right? It starts to look like she's a cartoon character. Okay? If that's the look you're going for and you're doing an anime character with a costume, that might be appropriate. But if not, I'm going to say that you want to scale that back to something where we had it before, that is a little bit softer and a little bit more realistic. About like that, right? A final before and after. Let's take a look at another example with a different subject. The second portrait is of a model that I work with often. Her name is Jo. So I've chosen this one because she's got nice bright eyes to begin with, and we can use that to change to any of the eye colors. Now, because she's blonde, she may very well have blue eyes. So let's go back into the Face AI tool and go down to the eye panel and change her iris color to blue. Okay, now you can see that the irises are too bright again. So that's that iris visibility slider. So usually what I'll do is if I am changing the color, I will turn the visibility down and use the enhancer one to bring that sparkle out. So you can see that it looks much more natural than if the visibility slider is higher. Let me just turn the tool off and on. Right? So you can see now it looks very natural that she might very well indeed have blue eyes. Right? What if she were to have green eyes? I find the green is a little bit too much color. I like the hazel eyes, which is great. That one here. And of course, again, you can play with the iris flare and make sure you whiten, but not too far. Enlarge eyes for her. You could go a little farther here. She's a little bit squinty, and that will help with opening the eyes. So let's see a before and after on Jill with an eye color change. She's gone from brown to a little bit more hazel. Remember to view it zoomed out again, and it still looks pretty natural if we look at the before and after. Please remember to click thumbs up and like this video, as well as subscribe to the channel if you enjoy this tutorial. One quick last example. On this portrait, she's got one eye that's closed a little bit, and her eyes were a little on the squinty side. So I'm just going to show you what it looked like before I dialed this up. Now notice that I've got this enlarged eye slider at 80, so I've got it quite high. So this is before and after. One more time. So see how narrow her eyes are? Maybe I got her in a half a blink. And it looks really natural to use that Enlarge Eye slider to literally just open her eyes. So use it sparingly if the person's eyes are naturally opened, and if they're a little bit more on the squinty side, try it a little bit higher. Let's back out and make sure that it doesn't look unnatural. You can see that her eyes are actually different sizes as well, because one is more closed than the other. Now, there's something that you could do to fix that. If you go into Photoshop and use Luminar as a plugin, that's a little bit more complex edit. I will show you that in a future video. Let's look at the overall before and after. I did do a bit of other editing on here using the Portrait AI tools inside of Luminar AI, and I'll cover those in future videos as well. So before and after. One last quick tip for you in terms of portrait retouching using Luminar AI is that you can copy and paste settings from one image to the next. You can do that by choosing Edit, Copy, or you can also right-click the image and choose Adjustments, Copy Adjustments, or you can use the keyboard shortcut Command-C, like so, and then choose the next thumbnail or image that you want to paste them into. If you don't see this little film strip at the bottom and you want to make that visible, just go to the View menu at the top and choose Show Film Strip right there. Once you've selected the image you want to paste onto, and you could do this to multiple images as well, you have the same options. You can right click and choose Adjustments, Paste. You can use Control V or go to the Edit menu. So notice that once I paste the settings in, it does the same settings to all of the faces. So as this is a group portrait, you'll notice that it's applied the hazel eye color and the enlarged eyes to all three faces. Let's take a look. So pay attention to all three faces. Let me turn off the film strip. Watch all three faces. The eyes will become slightly enlarged and the color will be enhanced. Boom, just like that. Now that may not be applicable if you don't want everybody's eye color to be the same. Just be aware when you're doing group portrait editing, when you apply settings from a single portrait, that it will apply to all the faces the same. Remember that bonus tip I talked about earlier? Let's dig into that a little bit more. This is something that I cover in great detail in my Portrait Fundamentals course, which you can get to by clicking the card in the upper right corner or down below in the description below the video. In the Portrait Fundamentals course, I talk about lighting direction and lighting pattern, how it falls on the face. And in this example here, what we're looking at particularly, again, I mentioned earlier, is the light in the eyes, and that is called a catch light. You want to make sure that the light source hits the subject's eyes. Two things will happen when light is hitting their eye. Their pupils will get smaller, and therefore you will see more of the iris, and their eyes will look more alive and sparkly. So you definitely want to have light hitting their eye. So when you see catch lights like this in the eyes, this is a good thing, right? If you don't see light in their eyes, your light source is probably either too far behind them or too far up high, too far above. Okay, so just make sure of where your light source is located in relative to position to the subject's eyes. If you can lower the light source, great. If not, you can rotate or adjust your model accordingly until you see that light hitting their eyes. So remember, catch lights are a good thing. If you want to continue learning, I have more videos using the Luminar AI portrait editing tools, including mouth and facial retouching. Check them out by clicking one of the videos on the screen now.